Hi everyone, this is Marissa from The Budgeting Wife, and welcome to my channel if you're new. Here on my channel, we talk about budgeting tips that will help you win with money. And if you've been here before, then welcome back. Today's video is going to be a little bit different than my normal budgeting videos, as I'm sharing about my experience with Fincon. Before we get into this video, if you are new and not yet subscribed, go ahead and scroll down and hit that subscribe button so you can be part of my YouTube family. So today's video is going to be a little bit different than my normal budgeting videos, as I'm going to be sharing with you my experience with Fincon, and I'm also going to be giving you some tips if you are looking to be a first-time Fincon attendee. So if you are at all interested in attending Fincon, you're definitely going to want to stick around. So maybe you don't even know what Fincon is. Fincon is a money and media event that happens once a year, and this year it was located in Orlando, Florida. So it is a conference, it's a few days, it was Wednesday through Saturday, and this is just a time where anyone who has a blog or a podcast, YouTube channel, any sort of influencer, speaker, author, anyone who has anything to do with personal finance is going to want to be there. And it is a huge blast. It is so fun to be able to network with people there and interact with brands. I learned absolutely so much about growing my business from being there for a week, and I can't recommend it enough if you are someone who's working on building a business that has anything to do with personal finance. So there you'll find people who are in the debt-free community, you'll find people who are in the FIRE movement, which is financial independence, retire early. Just about everyone is there. There are financial advisors, the whole sort. And it is just an awesome week to just get together with a bunch of other money nerds who are the same as you. It's just like your people all get together for a week. It's awesome. I do want to say though, Fincon is not for just like anyone who has an interest in personal finance. They did have a community pass this year, so I guess that is what it would be for, but I wouldn't like fly across the country and pay money to go to a conference if you don't have a brand that you're trying to build. Just as an FYI, if you're wondering if Fincon is right for you. But if you do have a platform and anything to do with personal finance, I can't recommend Fincon enough. It was seriously the best week. For me personally, I have a full-time job, and so doing everything here with The Budgeting Wife is very part-time for me. And so it was so nice to be able to go away for 6 days and just think and just work on my blog and YouTube channel for that long and just dream about what I wanted to become and how I'm going to build it. I came away with so many takeaways and so many things that I'm excited to implement to my business. And so during Fincon, there are ample times for networking. You're going to meet other bloggers, YouTubers, podcasters, all that kind of stuff. You're also going to meet with brands, which is great. You can use that to make Fincon pay for itself, actually, if you're able to walk away with a sponsorship, which so many people do. And then you're also going to be able to attend sessions where you learn business tricks, like how to grow your business, and all those sorts of things in so many realms. So therefore, it's just like the ultimate conference, you guys. It is seriously so much fun. I had an awesome time. So I just wanted to sit down and share a little bit about my experience going to Fincon 2018, and also give you some tips if you are looking to attend Fincon in 2019 or later and you're watching this video. If you're going to be a first timer at Fincon, you're definitely going to want to know these things. So what made me decide to come to Fincon this year? Last year I saw so many people on social media going to Fincon, and that was the first year that I'd ever heard of it. And I was like, what the heck is this? And then I had severe FOMO of seeing everyone else at this event, and I wish that I could be there too. And last year it was in Dallas, Texas. And so I was like, oh, I'd really like to go, but my brand was super small, and I was thinking like, there's no way that I should be able to go. So flashing forward to December of 2017, I was like telling my mom, like, I'm kind of interested in going to Fincon, but like, I don't know, like, you know, to pay for like all this stuff. And I also expressed to her that I was like nervous to meet all these people, and I don't love like huge social events, and I was just a little nervous about it. And so my mom said to me, Marissa, I really think you should go, and I will go with you just to be your travel buddy. And I was like, okay, that sounds good. So right then and there, we booked the tickets. I was super excited about it, and we were ready to go. So then a few months later, I heard from Fincon that CFSI, which is the Center for Financial Solutions Innovations, which is a nonprofit that helps people with lower incomes receive some financial education. They were running a contest for FinHealth Matters Day, which was in April. And to win the contest, you had to write a post about student financial health. So with that, I wrote a post about 12 ways to get out of student loan debt. And I will go ahead and leave a link to that post down below. You can check it out if you'd like. But as it turns out, I ended up being one of the winners from CFSI. And with that, I got a free, like, all expenses paid trip to Fincon. It was so awesome, you guys. Definitely put that on your calendar for Fin Health Matters Day next year to see if CFSI is doing the same contest, because you should definitely enter it if you are wanting to go to FinCon. So with that, I'd already bought my ticket, but they reimbursed me for my ticket and then said that I was going to be reimbursed $1,500 of travel expenses. So I was stoked. And then I finally got to go to FinCon, which was just last week. It was the last week of September. And I had an amazing time, you guys. It's the strangest thing. I've only met a handful of people before at a local Portland FinCon group. And so I haven't met like a ton of other FinCon people. And so I was a little nervous about that, but I have interacted with a lot of people on social media who are in the personal finance realm. So it was just so fun to be able to actually meet all of them in person. And I really became great friends with quite a few people. Budget Girl, Sarah from Budget Girl, Kelly from Freedom and a Budget, Troy from Dollar Dude, Justine from Debt Free Millennials, and Amanda from Debt Free and Sunny CA. They all became like our little group, and it was just so fun getting to finally meet them all in person, as I've seen them all online. But it was totally awesome to meet all of your virtual friends in real life. So I'll be sharing a little bit more of my experience as we go through the tips that I have for you if you are a first-time FinCon attendee. But all in all, it was such an amazing time, you guys. And if you're on the fence of wondering if it's worth it to pay to go to FinCon, it's definitely worth it. You should definitely go if you're at all thinking about it. And I hope that these tips will help you as you're planning your trip. So first off, Nick True from Mapped Out Money, I'll go ahead and leave a link to his channel down below as well. He is on the FinCon team, and on the first day of FinCon, he holds a first-timers orientation, which I would definitely recommend going to because it's going to give you all the tips and tricks and just like advice for being a first-timer, because it can be overwhelming. There's so much going on, and if you're not sure what to do as a first-timer, you're definitely going to want to go to this. So basically, I'm going to be sharing some of the things that he shared and then some things that I personally felt during the FinCon trip. Okay, so first off, what to pack. I am definitely an overpacker, and I did overpack for this trip, but I was really unsure of what I was going to be wearing and what I should really bring. So here are things that I found helpful in bringing for FinCon. The first thing, a checked bag. Bring a check size bag, but pack it like a carry-on because you will be receiving a lot of merchandise. So you're definitely going to want to have extra room in your suitcase. Cough drops. I didn't actually need this, but I knew a lot of people who did. You end up talking so much at FinCon that many people lose their voice. So bring some throat lozenges or cough drops for sure. Hand sanitizer. I went through an entire travel-sized bottle of hand sanitizer during this trip, and this is something they say to bring as well in the first-timer orientation, but you are shaking so many hands, and it's also right at the start of fall, and they have said, and they have warned you not to get the FinCon flu. So I would like walk around, shake hands, meet people and everything, but before I'd go to touch my face or eat, I would definitely lather on the hand sanitizer. So I would definitely recommend bringing some as well if you don't want to get sick. And for clothing, business casual or even casual will do. And this is where I was super confused on of what to wear. But basically, I would just suggest wearing something business casual, something that you would wear to your office. For me, that it looks like nice jeans and a nice shirt. So nothing too fancy, no pencil skirts or anything like that, or a blazer. But there are even people there who are wearing graphic t-shirts and jeans. So it's super chill. Don't worry about feeling like you're too dressed down. Also, don't forget to pack a sweater. FinCon was in Orlando this year, so obviously it's pretty warm, and I'm from Portland, so I'm not used to all the heat, but the conference rooms that they have at the hotel are very cold. So make sure that you pack a sweater that you can layer up with when you're going to all your sessions. Business cards, they are a must. You'll be handing out tons of business cards to people who are in the same realm as you, and also to vendors who are looking to partner with you. So make sure you have a ton of business cards and that yours is able to stand out. Also, consider packing some fancier-ish clothing. There may be some dinners that you'll go to if you're invited to a dinner. I was with CFSI our very first night, and it was great. So I dressed up a little bit for that. And there's also a closing party on Saturday night, and people can dress up for that a little bit more as well. So maybe consider packing one dressier outfit. Okay, my second tip, and this is what I was most scared about going in, but if this is you too, it should be a relief. You should definitely not be afraid to go meet people. The awesome thing about FinCon is that everyone is there to meet each other, and it just comes so naturally. I am the person who hates small talk, and I get super awkward when I meet people, but the great thing about FinCon is that everyone has the same shared experience, so it's really easy to introduce yourself, ask the person what they do, same, you know, they'll ask you the same, and just be able to engage in conversation that way. So this conference is all about networking and meeting a lot of people, and so don't be afraid to go up to people, introduce yourself, ask people, you know, what they're doing, and make those connections. And so what about those famous people that are in the personal finance realm? You know, Mr. Money Mustache was there, JD from Get Rich Slowly, the Financial Diet was there. There were our huge names who were at FinCon, and they're all walking around, they're all there. You can definitely go say hi to them, and I would recommend going to do so, but just try not to be weird, and also don't interrupt them. So if they're in a conversation with someone else, don't go just like bombard and be like, hi, I'm Marissa. But find a natural way to just like strike up conversation, keep it short, but introduce yourself. I would definitely recommend doing that. I was only awkward one time this whole conference, which is a win for me. But therefore, if I can do it, so can you. So don't feel awkward or weird, just be your normal self and go meet a ton of people. But more importantly than meeting those like big, huge names, meet all the people who are at the same sort of stage that you are with growing your business. So for me, that was hanging out with people like Budget Girl, Kelly from Freedom and a Budget, like all of them, they're a little bit more further ahead of me. So I love to be able to glean wisdom off of them. And since you're all at the kind of the same level, it's great to be able to bounce ideas off each other and collaborate. So I would definitely recommend finding your group of people that are similar to your size and also your niche. Okay, next tip is to schedule yourself, but not too much. So there are a ton of sessions that are going on, and many of them are like, there's like six sessions at the same time, so you're not gonna catch all of them. But look through and schedule yourself and pick the things that you're going to want to attend. But the good news is that there is a virtual pass that FinCon offers, which I also bought, and that has a recording of every single session that goes on during FinCon. You won't make it to all of them. I totally recommend getting the virtual pass so that you can still have flexibility in your schedule. Because even though you schedule yourself, you don't want to schedule yourself too much because again, FinCon is all about networking. So if opportunities come up to go have lunch with this person that you've been really wanting to meet up with and like ask questions, go do that, and therefore buy the virtual pass so you can catch all the sessions later. So definitely take a look at the schedule and make a plan for yourself, but hold that loosely and be flexible to saying yes to opportunities when they come up. For example, one night I had tentative plans, and then Sarah from Budget Girl came up to me and Amanda from Debt Free and Sunny CA, and she was like, hey, we're doing a YouTube live, doing a Q&A, do you guys want to join us? And we were like, heck yes. And so we got to join all YouTubers in that YouTube live. If you haven't seen it, I'll go ahead and leave a link to it down below, but it was an awesome time and just great to be able to have that flexibility and say yes to those FinCon opportunities when they came up. My next tip, or maybe just what you should expect, is to stay up late and barely sleep. So much of the interactions with FinCon happen late at night, so you're definitely going to want to make sure that you stay up for that and don't go to bed. Make sure that you are taking advantage of those networking opportunities. And also, sessions start around 8 a.m., so you might be getting 5-ish hours of sleep each night. Make sure that you schedule yourself a nap during the day, but just expect to be staying up late and not getting much sleep. Which brings me to this next tip, which is to stay at the hotel that the conference is at. So this year the conference was at the Rosen Shingle Creek Hotel in Orlando, and there were a bunch of people who stayed on site at the hotel and then others who stayed at a different hotel off site. And we stayed on site and I am so thankful that we did. It was great that in between sessions, if I was really tired because I barely got any sleep, I could just go up to the room and take a nap for a half hour. It was also great too late at night if I was out till 1 a.m. to just be able to go right up to my hotel room and I didn't have to worry about commuting back and forth from the hotel. If you're staying at a different hotel, you can expect to be commuting in between. You can expect to having to wake up earlier and go to bed later because you're going to have to worry about that gap in between the commute. So if you can, I highly recommend booking a room at the resort that the conference is being held. You can even find a roommate. Fincon has a roommate spreadsheet, so you can like check that out and find a roommate to share a room for Fincon. But I would definitely suggest finding a room at the resort that the conference is held. My next tip is to stay through Saturday. So the conference goes from Wednesday through Saturday and it ends Saturday night at like 11:30 at night because that is when they have the closing party. But I knew that there were a lot of people who left midday on Saturday. Don't do that. Stay till the very end. The closing party was a ton of fun. It was just great to celebrate everything and be there with your friends. It was so awesome. So make sure that you head home on Sunday and not Saturday. And last but not least, book your ticket early. Prices will go up throughout the year, so make sure that you get in as soon as possible. FinCon this next year will be held in Washington, D.C., and I am super excited about it. I already have my ticket, and I think that you should as well. So I'll leave a link to FinCon's website so you can sign up if you are at all interested. I look forward to seeing you there. If you see me, definitely come up and say hi. I love meeting everyone in this community. It's so much fun. So that is all I have for you guys today. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope that it gave you some insight to FinCon and gave you some tips if you are looking to be a first-time FinCon attendee. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, and also don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you are new. And if you have attended a FinCon before, leave me a comment down below and let me know what your biggest tip is for fully enjoying FinCon. I'd love to hear what you guys have to say. And with that, I will see you guys in the next video. Bye, guys.